Hey, what's up, gardening friends? How's everybody doing? Hope you're good. I am great.
Finally doing an orchid video.
I know, it's been a while. People been asking me. And so I thought I'd bring you along while I go ahead and repot this epidendrum. This is an Epidendrum Radicans. It's not any special hybrid or anything like that or cross. It's your regular orangish kind of ready flower. That's not a word. Reddish orange flowers. That's what I was trying to say. You can see it has really taken over this pot. It seems nice and healthy, so unpotting it and repotting it shouldn't be a big deal, but we will see. I did go ahead and sanitize my surface because I do a lot of potting on this table, and that fusarium lives in the soil, so kept that nice and clean. And as I'm sure you've gathered, I'm putting this in a hanging basket. So first things first, just gonna get in here and pop this out of the pot and see what's going on with those roots. All right, that was rooted in there pretty heavily. From looking at this, I can tell this is potted up in just potting soil. Not terribly uncommon for an epidendrum. Because I overwinter these indoors in my grow space, I'm still gonna use potting soil, but I want it to be mixed with some other things so that it drains really freely, because as much as I try, if it drops below 30 outside, then it's not staying that warm in the grow space. Probably going to be in the 50s, and if it just happens to be wet, then you rot and all those fun things. Fun things. There's nothing fun about rot. That's another reason I'm using the hanging basket with this coconut liner. It'll dry out a little bit faster, but I can still have it mixed in with a potting soil. All right, in here I already have a hefty amount of orchid bark and some perlite. I'm gonna fill this up the rest of the way, or close to the rest of the way, with potting soil and blend it together. Okay, so now I have that blended up. Gonna go ahead and start filling this up and get the orchid in there. Oh wait, actually, need to go ahead and get this guy out of that old soil first. Alright, so I've gotten most of the soil, if not just about all of it, removed from in there. Roots are looking good, nice and healthy. So I think this should take being repotted just fine. Though I may not have mixed up enough soil. I'm just reaching in here, pulling this back, and getting the soil pushed down in there. Yep, gonna have to mix some more up. I'll be right back. I can see this is its old mix here. There's a lot of pumice in there. So it was in a nice, gritty, sharply draining soil before this, which is nice, that's pretty much what I've done here. Don't worry, I will be sanitizing this between use. All right, that's all done. It looks kind of wild and crazy, but I like that. This little guy over here, back here, can you see it? No, you can't. Right here, here it is. There's a straggler here that's ready to pop off. I'm actually gonna just snap that off because, one, it was bothering me. Like, it was bothering me a lot. And it has the roots and everything in there, so I can take this. I'm just gonna set this down. I'm gonna put this down here in the other end where there's a little bit more surface area on the soil and push it down a smidge. Well, that's it though. Okay. Okay, guys, you're a little bit crazy. Wait, no, it's not. I need to water this in. Oh, I don't know where my hose nozzle went, so this will have to do. I mean, I have an idea where it went. I just don't feel like going and finding it, to be honest. See how quickly that drains? That's exactly what I want. Potentially a little bit unnecessary. The epidendrum orchids are just so incredibly forgiving and easy. But like I said, just because of the winter time and whatnot, I want to be safe, make sure it drains really, really well so I don't have to worry about it rotting. With any other orchid, I don't think I would bump it up in size quite this much. There's probably a good 3 to 4 inches of space around the sides of the root mass that's in there. Generally, an inch or two is right about where you want to be surrounding it, but these epidendrum orchids, they grow so fast, so crazily that, I mean, it's going to need to be repotted probably again next year. I wouldn't be surprised by that anyways. Man, it's in so many different directions, it does not want to focus. I also kind of just like the idea of the epidendrum being in a hanging basket, because I sort of like that wild look. I'm going to find a place where I can hang it up in my trees. Not quite positive where just yet. I just knew that I wanted it in the basket, so it might stay on that stand for a little while. It needs to be someplace I can easily access with the hose. It's gonna probably need to be watered daily. In the ground, they're more drought tolerant in a hanging basket, and probably not so much. Beauty's in the eye of the beholder. Maybe not the most attractive thing to most people, but I think this is beautiful. And it will definitely be even more so when it starts to bloom again, which shouldn't be long. I mean, these things usually bloom off and on for me pretty much throughout the year. I usually give all of mine full sun when we have extremely high temperatures. When we start to hit like the upper 90s and triple digits, I usually scoot them into the shade a little bit just so that they don't cook and get scorched like these palm trees behind it. Can't move those are too heavy. Easy plant, one of my favorite orchids. I really like the wild look to them, especially when they start to get all these really cool wild aerial roots coming out of them. Why I love Vandas so much. And over time, this will probably actually start to adhere to the sides of the basket and sort of take over. I actually had a really cool basket. I still have it, but I don't have any coconut liner for it, but it's like a tall, long, I'll show you. This guy, see that shape? Pardon the mess, that's the behind the scenes stuff. But yeah, that would have been neat because it would have been able to kind of grow along the bottom and come out, but I think maybe when I divide it up and do that next year, that's the direction I'll grow. For now, I think this 10-inch basket's just fine. Oh, and one of the other really awesome things about having this in a hanging basket is that I like the idea of having it up in the air, up in the trees, because the pollinators really love the flowers on the epidendrum. The butterflies and hummingbirds and bees really seem to be drawn to it a lot. And it's like the idea of being able to have that fun, exotic, tropical color up high, kind of naturalizing the tropical wild aesthetic a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to clean up a little bit, and I have another epidendrum to repot, but this is gonna be a little bit different because I think I'm just gonna take it from its nursery can, just drop it into a fresh pot. All right, and for the next epidendrum, I'm actually just gonna move it from one pot to the other, this pot right here being the other. I picked this up from a local nursery, and they had told me that, or the main person there had told me she had just repotted it. You told me what type of soil she was using. It's the same grower's mix that I use. And I'm pretty sure it's just in straight up potting soil. It's been that way for a few months, and it's actually been doing really, really well. There's a lot of new growth, and I'm pleasantly surprised with it being in just pure potting soil. However, like I was just saying, with this hanging basket, in the wintertime, I don't want it in straight up potting soil. Way too prone to rot. So this is the pot I'm using. It's from Home Depot. I've had it for quite a while. I cleaned it up and sanitized it and everything, which was probably unnecessary because it hasn't had anything in it forever. It's been out in the sun, but just to be safe, I went ahead and did that. There is one issue here though, and it's that the drainage dish is attached to the pot, which I hate. It drives me crazy. Because when it goes through that tiny little hole there, the water tends to just sit in that reservoir, and that wicks back up, and it just causes problems. So I'm gonna go ahead and use my diamond bit and run some water through here and drill a bigger hole through the middle. All right, so I've got my hole drilled in there. That way the water can move right out of that drainage dish. So I'm going to prepare my soil blend. I've got my knife here, gonna cut this open carefully and away from my body. I'm actually out of orchid bark, so I'm just using lava stone instead. It's gonna serve the same purpose. In fact, it's a little bit better because it's not gonna break down as quickly. When organics break down, they clump together, make like a mud, and things stick together and becomes more water retentive. And acidity and all types of things can build up. So the lava rock really is probably better to go with anyways. And there's lots of surface area and pores in there for all types of good bacteria and fungi to grow. So it'll work fine. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop this other guy out of the pot and see what's going on in there. All right, so it's not root bound at all. Like I said, the people at the nursery, the main person who does the tropicals, told me she had just repotted this when I got it like a month or two ago. So it really probably doesn't even need new soil, but I just, like I said, I want it mixed up something a little bit more airy that'll drain faster for the winter months.
Come in here and get as much of the soil out of there as I can. I'm gonna go ahead and start pouring this in there. Get my orchids set down.
So I have no idea if this is in focus. I apologize if it's not. I can't see my monitor. And I'm on the other side of my microphone. That's probably not very helpful either.
I'm trying my best to take any roots that were already under the soil and make sure they stay there.
Keep it pulled back a little bit and slowly fill it in all the way around.
Gonna water that in real quick and get things cleaned up. Hey, you see all that water moving out the bottom? That's exactly what I wanted to see. Ooh, things are getting kind of dark. Fine, I'm done anyways. Time to wrap this up. So there it is, both my Epidendrum Radicans potted up two separate ways, both perfectly fine for the orchids. We'll get to kind of watch these and see how they do. I'm interested to see the contrast between the two. The soil medium's different since I use lava rock in one and bark and perlite in the other. And one's in a glazed pot. The glazed pots don't always breathe as well. But with that sharp drainage from the lava stone being mixed in there, that shouldn't be an issue.
At least, let's hope not. Well, everybody's doing well. Thanks for hanging out with me while I get these guys repotted. I have a few more orchid videos that are going to be coming out. One is I need to go around and show off some blooms and progress and whatnot. And I need to repot my zygopetalum, which I am terrified of doing, just because it seems so often people repot those and they just die. But it's time to do it. It's been so long that if I don't do it, it's going to die. So, and it's just, I can get a new one. It's not a special hybrid. So that's going to be later. I'm rambling.
Got all my social media stuff down below, down there in the roots of the video. You can follow me and I'll follow you back. It's a lot of fun seeing everybody's pictures and what they have going on with their plants. And comment down below while you're down there. I love talking to everybody.
And don't forget to leave the video a thumbs up. It helps so much and I really appreciate every single one of those. Thank you so, so much. Subscribe as well. It's actually down there. And hit that notification bell. I upload multiple times a week. And as always, everybody, most importantly, keep on growing. Bye-bye.